Events like tonight are significant. They're significant because you've come to recognise the women who've broken the mould and, most importantly, who are inspiring other women to absolutely go for it.
In Australia, I think we're blessed, and many of them are in this room tonight, with a lot of intelligent, smart women who have all the markings to be the best leaders of any FTSE 500 company that they choose to work for, and they're experts in their field.
I think it's just the recognition of women in the industry, and especially with trades. The national percentage of women in trades is about 3%, so the pool is really tiny. So to put any light on that and to try and build that pool of women in trades is really important.
We hear some fantastic things about how the statistics are moving forward and a lot more women are getting engaged in engineering and STEM, which is absolutely true. We're making a lot of headway there. I think the difficulty still lies in retaining women in these roles, so I think that's where the next wave of change needs to come.
I love the opportunity to engage with women who are earlier in their careers to share some of what I've learned. I find it is very affirming and very helpful to me, because when you're explaining something to someone else, sometimes it clicks for you as to what you do and why you do it.
Some of the visible changes that Michael's brought about is that at each of our leadership groups, at each of our plant location leadership groups, gender diversity now forms part of the discussion at their leadership meetings. It's not something on the side, it's actually a core part of making our business at Alcoa a better business.
Amazingly, really proud of the crew. Regardless of if we won or not, I'm still really, really proud of the crew. My heart was just beating when they announced us as winners, and it was just, I'm so proud.